Is there anything I can do for you? Is there anything I can do for you?
I don't think so, baby. Who's that? It's killing me.
Do you want me to crush it up for you?
Do
you want me to crush it up for you? I should have been doing that while you were eating, I'm sorry.
Collins Worth now for Monday, January 31st. This is CTV News at 11:30. Tonight's messy mix of winter makes a tough go for cleanup crews across the region. The cost of COVID, more lives lost to the virus. A new lesson plan, students head back to class in uncertain times. Storm. Then a big drop in temperatures made the cleanup particularly difficult, especially on sidewalks. CTV's Bruce Frisco with our top story.
Keeping up. The temperatures overnight were not
mention of another storm sparks fears of flooding for many Sydney homeowners. Some residents want a $15 million grant from the province to be used to find a solution. CTV's Kyle Moore with that story. The ground is dry today in Sydney. The residents of this neighborhood are flooded with emotions after the area was drenched for the third weekend this month.
This is inevitable and just reasonably by people out.
Chelsea O'Neill says she's prostrated, waiting for the city to fix an area that now floods on a regular basis and wants the municipality to move residents affected if they can't fix the problem.
It would be a huge asset to have the city remove those houses from that area to be able to build a pond or a reservoir or whatever they're calling it to store that water.
Know that you're being heard. We are working very, very hard to find different mitigating projects.
CBRN Mayor Maggie McDougall and councillors will soon meet to decide how to spend a $15 million one-time grant as part of provincial equalization payments.
We were presented with a staff list of, some ideas on where we could put that investment into, and so now it's the work of council to ponder that list and bring back what other priorities and projects might be.
McDougall says she suspects flood mitigation will be part of those discussions.
The truth is CBRN needs some major climate change adaptation fund.
City and political science professor.
Is there anything I can do to help you, baby?
No. Just relax there and chill out. Get this and then come over and lay down with you.
Okay. Oh no. Did you drop your pill? Can I help?
To the utility review board since 2012. Since then, the rate has increased annually around 1%, which is the cost of inflation.
They're a company worth tens of billions of dollars, and the maintenance that we need, the basic maintenance.
I dropped the fucking thing on the floor.
Has no accountability to its customers under the current regulatory structure, and that needs to change. In their application, Nova Scotia Power proposed a service access fee to charge solar customers a fee to sell energy back to the grid. The solar industry has railed against it, saying the new fees would devastate the industry. Rankin said the solar fee could be a distraction tactic or bargaining chip used to get the 10% rate increase.
They could be aiming high, hoping to get somewhere in the middle, and I'm fearful that even the solar exercise is a distraction from the rate increase that they're asking.
It's anticipated the Utility Review Board will open up its public review of the application later this week. That means the public will have its chance to weigh in. Jesse Thomas, CTV News.
Most New Brunswick students return to the classroom today for the first time since going on break for the holidays. But there are concerns about cases and potential staffing shortages going forward. CTV's Laura Lyle with that story.
For the first time since the start of the new year, K-8 students in New Brunswick returned to the classroom today. There's still anxiety around everything that could happen health-wise. That exists whether we're in school or not. The province made the decision to move to virtual classrooms due to the rapid rise in cases driven by the Omicron variant, a wave that's still with us. An Anglophone West School District Superintendent David McTimony says they prepare for the possibility of staff being out due to COVID.
We have redeployed our teacher by trade teachers that work in the district office setting, about 70 of them, coordinators and teacher leads, and redeployed them back out to the school setting. So they're there on standby.
New Brunswick Teachers Association President Connie Keating, meantime, said they outlined a number of items to government they wanted to see addressed before the return to in-person learning, including high-quality masking for teachers and access to rapid tests.
We've been told by Minister Carney that those things would be in place for today. And so at this point, we're trusting that has happened.
A statement from the Department of Education sent late this afternoon says that school districts did not report any major issues around the return to in-person learning. Laura Lyle, CTV News, St. John.
With hundreds of people in hospital and hundreds of healthcare workers off the job because of COVID-19, the healthcare system continues to struggle with the latest wave of the pandemic. It's not getting easier on a daily basis. Here's CTV's Patrick Hastings.
Three additional deaths were reported today in Nova Scotia as Omicron continues to sweep across the Maritimes.
This particular wave has hit Atlantic Canada particularly hard.
351 people are currently hospitalized with COVID-19 in Nova Scotia. There are 93 people receiving specialized care in a COVID-19 designated unit.
I would say we're at capacity. We were over capacity, a bit over capacity in the acute side, on the acute care side this week, and a little under on the ICU side. But overall, our capacity is right at about 100%.
Dr. Trevor James expects to see more hospitalizations over the next 1 to 2 weeks in Atlantic Canada.
Nobody more than healthcare providers wants to see Omicron and have COVID in the rear view mirror. But right now, I suspect that we'll still see a slight increase in hospitalizations once the peak of the wave is there across the region.
There are currently 314 healthcare workers off the job in Nova Scotia, either because they've been diagnosed with COVID-19, are waiting for test results, or were exposed to the virus.
It has a tremendous impact on our surgical services. Hi, baby.
Hi, sweetheart.
How are you?
Cancer
surgeries every day.
Right.
And to get as many people.
Is there a big mess in the carpet?
Is there a big mess in the carpet?
No. Luthier says there's still a lot of COVID activity in Nova Scotia and is encouraging people who test positive to report it.
So it's really important for them to put those results in to the health authority if they're getting rapid test positive, and it keeps the public health team well informed about who's at risk and that out in the community.
Health officials are reminding Nova Scotians to continue to get vaccinated to prevent severe disease as we continue through the Omicron wave. Natasha Pace, CTV News, Halifax.
The most difficult month of the pandemic in New Brunswick is now coming to a close. A total of 78 people in New Brunswick died in January related to COVID-19. CTV's Nick Moore has that story.
An individual in their 20s who lived in the St. John Health area is one of five new COVID-19 fatalities being reported in New Brunswick today, bringing the provincial pandemic death toll to 238. The number of people in hospital with COVID-19 is down by 12. 152.
The spike has slowed, but we're not saying that the spike still won't occur. We just slowed it down with the measures that were put in place.
Hospitalizations remain high, but Dr. Mark McMillan says the numbers appear to be heading in the right direction, or at least holding steady.
What I think we've learned is that these lockdowns can help.
A level 3 lockdown can move to level 2 Friday at midnight.
Hospitalization is definitely very important, but you also have to look at the general population as well. Their mental health, their ability to get up and do things.
of St. John.
The commission investigating the April 2020 mass murder of 22 people in Nova Scotia has released a statement saying the proceedings were delayed after some participants requested more time to prepare. The commission is saying they heard the concerns of family members of the victims after public hearings initially set to begin last fall and postponed until February 22nd.
Reports of harassment, signs being placed on the Terry Fox statue and dishonoring the tomb of the unknown soldier.
We won't give in to those who fly racist flags. We won't cave to those who engage in vandalism or dishonor the memory of our veterans.
But that wasn't Brian Fraser's experience. He is a veteran and went to Ottawa to support truck drivers. He just got back, he says, with a sense of hope.
Just people just happy to see support and encouragement and no hate. And put me in tears, I don't know how many times.
He disagrees with protesters who showed any signs of disrespect and says organizers gave protesters instructions on how to report a problem if someone behaves badly.
They're not there to make a mess. They're there, they want to be listened to, they want to be heard.
On the streets of Halifax, many believe the protesters have a different idea of what freedom is.
We face freedom on peace order in government. That's where our freedom comes from. I don't see any peace, I don't see any order, and I certainly don't see any good government from these people. So yes, they're hurting their own cause.
Sarah Plowman, CTV News, Halifax.
Time for another break on CTV News. When we come back, Kayla Mitchell has your maritime weather forecast. Our news continues after this. Kayla, the cleanup from the weekend storm continues, but at the same time, what can we anticipate long-range forecast-wise?
Yeah, it's that time of year where the next weather system ever seems like it's that far away. We do got a break for a couple of days here, but towards the end of this week, Thursday, Friday, and then for Nova Scotia, potentially into Saturday, slow-moving weather front coming in. Now, it's expected to bring a mix of precipitation along with it. With that mix of precipitation, it's not impossible for some parts of America to pick up a significant amount of snow.
You decided to go for the whole thing, baby?
Huh?
Did you decide to go for the whole thing?
No.
Well, take your glasses over here. Just take your glasses right here.
Locations indicate
St. Stephen and St. John. Prince Edward Island tomorrow, high temperatures minus 12 to minus 8. That holds the temperatures up west in the province. Mix of sun and cloud, light northwest winds. For Cape Breton for tomorrow, most high temperatures will be around minus 5 to minus 6. And then for eastern areas, mainland Nova Scotia, between minus 8 and minus 5. Cold day for northern and central parts of the province. Province average with a high near minus 10, minus 8 at Truro and Enfield. City centers, Halifax and Dartmouth, with highs close to minus 6, minus 5 at Winnipeg. In Apples Valley with highs around minus 6, and down around the South Shore, southwest of Nova Scotia, high temperatures between minus 6 and minus 3. Taking a look at the 7-day forecast here, Groundhog Day coming up on Wednesday. For New Brunswick, increasing cloudiness. Temperatures actually recover a fair bit. There'll be a chance of flurries. Then we get that front arriving Thursday to Friday. May initially start as a mixture of some snow, some ice, and rain. For New Brunswick,
the
temperatures fall with it. Turns over to periods of snow in the forecast for Friday. And a chance of flurries for Saturday and Sunday. Mix of sun and cloud, cold weekend ahead. For Nova Scotia,
no, it's just
coming up on Wednesday, Groundhog Day.
No, it's just moving.
Temperatures moderate. On Thursday, that front starts as some light rain, but then on Friday, as temperatures fall, that rain turning through some icy weather, ice belts, freezing rain, and over to snow. Snow may continue for Nova Scotia into Saturday morning. Sunday, it makes some sun and cloud, but a chance of flurries on Monday. And for Prince Edward Island in the forecast, Groundhog Day Wednesday, smooth sailing, mix of sun and cloud. And the front arrives Thursday into Friday. They initially start as a mix, but as temperatures fall with it, turns over to some snow for Friday. Chance of flurries on Sunday. On Saturday, Sunday, a mix of sun and cloud.
Sure. Bow in my hair.
No, my baseball cap.
Oh,
hi, Cops.
You're on your own?
No, you're just a baby.
Oh, I got Pampers on.
It seems little boy Pampers with special pan on the front to soak up. Because boys pee more than girls.
Do boys pee more, baby? How come I didn't know that?
Oh, because you didn't have a baby.
Why do they pee more?
Because they're, well, not pee more, it's just can make more of a mess because they pee out of the front. So they put a little extra.
Oh, yeah, because they only can point in any which way. Is it only that big when they're babies?
Yeah.
It's like your clitoris.
You know, it's like half my pinky finger.
Yeah, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. And he'll go away.
Of course, what he'd really like as a birthday present is to be able to play regular gigs again.
Hopefully, I'll get to do these shows because God knows I might not make it to 76, so I want to get him in.
I'm 75.
Oh my God, what?
One of his favorite memories for more than a half century.
He was only like 45 when I met him.
Yeah.
Was that 1999?
Because it just, you know, hung around with them. We were there for a week and each time. And so you got to know them and you get to see what they do.
He's still young. All right, looking in the face.
These days, he still plays a mean guitar and plans to keep on performing as long as I can. If it gets to the point where I can't do it.
He just didn't have a very good personality.
Ryan McDonald, CTV News, West Bay.
You know what I mean?
Oh, wait a minute. Okay, right now. My baby?
I said he's not a bad looking, he wasn't a bad looking guy or anything. He just had a really crappy personality.
Yeah, there you go. You chasing my baby?
Well, he was a skin hound and he could just tell.
I'm gonna have to go out and see him.
Well, he's an old man now. He probably wouldn't even recognize me.
Yeah, but it still happens, baby. Mainly sunny. Yes, we recommend.
Does he have to be recommended?
You attacked my baby.
He didn't attack me.
What did he do?
He just tried to pick me up.
That's attacking, isn't it? You were attacked, baby.
This is the House of Music in Budapest. It opens doors for visitors and concert goers.
Glass walls are built around
natural light to speak.
Should shoot the fucking old prick.
The walls are built around inside patterns to allow for consistent quality.
See, I want some money for that. I got to pay medication. It caused me a bunch of pain to tax.
Series of exhibition
fucker. You 75-year-old fucking snake.
Would you do me a favor?
What is it, baby? Bird. Lick. Water. Water.
Can I have the rest of us in the spoon?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Have a great night. Thanks for watching. We shall see you soon.
I already told you that.
I was just making sure.
Are you?
Yeah. How do you feel?
I feel good.
You feel better?
Yes, baby. Call me baby girl.
Call me baby. You call me baby today.
You're 36, 24, 36.
No, I'm not 24 anymore.
No? What are you, 25?
Yeah.
Well, that's not bad, though.
That's funny. I'm a little bloated.
Are you bloated?
Yeah.
Do I get to give you enema today?
Probably very early tomorrow morning.
It's sometimes hard to gauge just how much snow is around when you have such blowing snow like that, but it will say Moncton with the 40 centimeters of snow, Charlottetown, PGI,
37 really centimeters, they registered. I have to be really relaxed.
So 30 centimeters, so a lot of digging out today. You can see some kind of cooler temperatures today, but back to a more seasonal -5 right now in Halifax. It's -15 up in
Northern Brunswick. He's fucking it up.
And -9 in Charlottetown right now.
This
things kind of back to normal
weather
today.
Guy.
Weather-wise, after that storm,
look at the new separator. Guy?
No, they had the new guy on here, though.
In terms of things this evening. And that's a good thing, because we got
can't
enough snow last
night. Can't
hold
a candle to Steve Murphy.
West 20 kilometers gusting
what?
Up to 40.
Can't hold a candle to Steve Murphy.
No, Big Steve.
Big Steve.
Let's look up to Northern
Big rat Steve.
He's a rat?
He's a rat.
Why?
Because he can't shut his big mouth. He's got to tell everybody everything.
Well, so what did he rat? What did he do?
He told the wrong side of the story for one person and he gave the other person that side of the story.
Oh. I was coming out of the door. Speaking of rats, I was coming out of the door, and the broad that was at the end of the hallway was pulling the extension cord out of the wall.
Your white one? And what, just left it there?
She pulled it out, and then she just ran down the hall like a little rat. Went into her fucking rat box.
Yeah. What the fuck does she care?
Doesn't cost her a fucking thing.
Won't make no sense. She ain't paying for it. From Monday to Tuesday, she don't know what's going on. You might have had a big flood in here. Drawing stuff out.
You know what? That's a good point. She's a spy for my mother.
Is she?
Excuse me.
Oh, can I look that now?
Yeah, she calls my mother and tells my mother everything I'm doing here.
Does she?
Like when me and Cal had a fight, she called my mother and my mother just showed up here. I didn't even know.
Did she stay long?
No, she stayed long enough to go out on the balcony and tell Cal to get the fuck out. And he left.
Yeah?
He was afraid of her.
Of course, I would have been too.
But she shoved me around a bit.
Shoved you around?
Yeah.
Why?
Because she was trying to get through the hallway, and I was like, Mom, I don't know what you're doing here, but... And she's just like, oh, move out of my way, and she shoved me. later that day, Cal made fun of me and said, your mother bullies you or something. It made me so mad that I waited until 5 o'clock the next morning and I woke him up throwing shit at his head.
Yeah. Well, he was the one making all kinds of noise, all right?
Yeah, and the lady at the hall called my mother. Where's that? Oh. And those who just struggle to make ends meet. Is that in Halifax?
I think so, baby.
Could get a free haircut.
Yeah.
Sometimes a simple conversation in our chair can just uplift somebody's day.
It's the first time Raven Flair Hair Salon has done this initiative. Just a swab is greatly appreciated.
No, sweetheart, it's in Ottawa. This is Monday, right?
This is Tuesday.
Okay.
This is T-U-E-S-D-A-Y.
Oh, look, that's the new guy.
Is it?
Yeah. See, it's gonna snow again.
Yeah, in a week or so.
Blair says, however, you don't need a husky to enjoy this sport. It doesn't matter if it's a husky, to a poodle, to a shepherd, to whatever.
I think it's this
week. 35 pounds and it can pull and have the energy and the drive.
It said something about snow.
They can definitely
do it. Wasn't real clear.
No problem. But they're bred to run and pull. And if you let them go and they're just natural. It's amazing.
Are you itchy?
Most of their runs are along the trails through
no.
Windsor, Essex.
I'm trying to flash at you.
Flash me?
Flash at you.
I don't think your bum is flashing. I think you have to show your bird. There you go, that's flashing.
Hey, he's laughing at my bird.
And no, it's funny when you when guys flip it around like that, like it's made of nothing.
Yeah.
Do you swing some sausage?
Swing sausage, baby.
You've been known around town to swing some sausage. Started yesterday, you mean?
Really?
Is today Groundhog Day?
Mm-hmm.
Is today second?
Second. Groundhog Day, isn't it?
No, it's February. No, tomorrow's Groundhog Day.
Oh, yeah. That's right, baby. Baby girl.
Very annoying. What should I put on the top? I'll do it, baby, if you like.
That baby, I fondled you and molested you.
That's very comfortable.
I fondled mommy. My mommy's here. Where's that clean one down there, baby? Is somebody in war picture?
Garbage man cleaning tips to quiet life information. Think of a movie and I'll search for it.
How about
season one, season two.
Wherever.
Season two, season one. The show starts getting good.
Yeah. Come on, baby.
No, just...
Previously on Dexter, I promise to say if I know if we got out of really is my first good friend.
We need to go after the root cause. Blood-sucking, soulless defense attorney. Helen?
Yeah. Walk in the park to discredit you, counselor.
Try it. Don't
find out the one I'm trying
to. You should be. Yes.
Did you get a fright?
I did. I got startled.
Baby was startled.
Is still giving me the runaround. Until we know Pink's full identity, there's not much to go on.
a long conversation with Dexter Morgan.
That's yelling pretty
hard.
Killed
him, baby.
Who killed him? Oh,
Dexter.
He killed
another cop.
His buddy. The beginning's good. The opening.
Huh?
The opening was good.
Yeah. How about this?
I think it should just be that. With the music and the watch the show then.
Yeah. My buns are on it?
Yeah, I wouldn't have got canceled. Extra Tabasco sauce.
No, you're moving something over the floor.
I don't know who lives up there, but fuck me. Sound like a racehorse when they have a piss.
Yeah, I heard that. Hey, Booba.
Yeah.
Come, Booba. Booba? Baby? Well, I'll wait for you. Maybe don't go to rush. I love you.
She ain't all that,
baby.
She ain't all that?
She ain't all that. You're gorgeous. She can do it there.
Thank you, baby.
You're welcome. I keep my hand keeps going there, baby. I don't know why. There's something down there.
Can I eat my toast?
I'm just rubbing.
What? It's like a full meal deal. I did what?
You spilled my water.
I did.
You tipped the bottle over. It didn't spill though.
You know, a lot of different emotions.
Your feet don't stink, baby, or get dirty.
The floor's really dirty. People like George and the other guy walking here with their boots on.
Yeah.
I don't know what's on in the snow, dog piss.
Dog do.
Human pee.
Human pee. That's just I pee up there in the alleyway. Like a dog.
Everybody's doing it.
Picking up and chewing it.
Yeah, I might think it's funny, but...
It's my loving mother.
Mm. You alright?
She lied to him, baby.
Did Rita just lie to
me? He picked up on third one that counts. And she's lying, it's the baby. Or it's husband's. Third husband. She's the third fucking.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I remember when his mom, or her mom sent her the card or something.
Yeah, women's right.
Mm-hmm.
He gave me so much. Darling Rita, once you were a dream and a prayer, now our future is as bright as the sun glinting off the morning dew, and I'd lie there.
Cute.
You, baby.
Spread's really good.
You know, when you toast up the air, baby. Is your bugs trying to climb over?
Yeah, that's a crap. Probably man who called us, they found your door open. Yeah, he called me too.
No.
Well, then you just take a good look around and see what's missing.
I'm gonna spill your water, baby.
Hard to tell.
Yeah.
Your neighbor, Miss Levin, saw someone hanging around the mailboxes. Latin, kind of burly, goatee. Ring any bells?
Ramon Prado.
Whoa.
Miguel warned you that his death wasn't going to be the end of things.
So his plan was to make me hire a housekeeper.
You're suit for your wedding. That person. Ramon Prado's like a cut-shot animal. You know what to do with him, man.
the ring to tie Miguel to Ellen Wolf's murder. Threatened to destroy Ramon's sainted brother's reputation forever. That's enough to get Ramon to back down.
Sarah?
Dexter?
How are you?
Honestly, not so great.
Well, baby.
Huh?
You're laughing at me again.
No, I wasn't.
You were sneaking.
I was choking on his toast.
Were you? You looked at me and I made you fed up.
No, it's really dry.
I'm with Miami Metro Homicide. I think you can track him down.
Before she left me, she left me.
This man is in custody. Jorge Orozco, a.k.a. George King, affectionately known back home as El Fiel, to blame. Orozco was a captain in the Resistencia Nicaragüente. He headed an interrogation unit.
He tortured people for him.
It took a couple of months and a lot of wrangling that my budget request by the game to. Homicide is going to get a little less for money.
Oh, that's great. We should get one of those crime site images. Have you seen them? Their pictures are amazing.
Yeah, that's what you'd spend it on? Because I was thinking maybe we'd spend it on adding another detective to our squad. Maybe somebody who saved a life on CI, who ID'd our skin. Something good?
My detective shield.
Well, big news.
It's gigantic news. All the Gloria has to do is sign the papers and I'm golden. Well, I'm silver.
We should celebrate.
Yeah, come on.
I mean, later. I gotta pick up the kids and then go to the tailor.
Oh, yeah.
No, Dad would be proud. It still means something, no matter how flawed he was.
Yeah, because you're getting married. I'm making detective. The Morgans are gonna be alright. I'll see you at the rehearsal tomorrow.
Okay.
Yo, Ray.
again. Any progress on my dad's CI files?
Well, he knew a lot of folks, I'll give him that.
Anyone of interest?
Not in closing everything in. Are you sure you want me to? Some things are better left in the box.
I need to put a face on her.
And all the details isn't going to change the fact that he was messing around with me this lot. I'll set him up as soon as I can.
Thank you.
City Council has voted to make the freeway interchange near my house. Miguel Bravo. I drive that way every single day.
He's a hero.
Maybe.
Happens. Happens to all of us.
Imagine. I'm sorry. You're the only other person who knows the truth. Maybe it's time we let you know the secrets.
There's nothing.
Bravo, Baba.
Hey, boo boo
baba.
He doesn't have a life
anymore. Hey, boo boo baba. Your sugar bear, crisp.
He still might not.
Your crispy sugar bear.
Yep.
You're 36, 24, 36.
I'm just the bear, like I've always been all my life, bear.
And you're the great Pawan.
Great Pawan. Yeah. Somebody's got some good pots someplace.
Oh, my back is so baby.
For falling in the chair.
Can you get a big thing burrito and a side of beans, maybe a little bit?
Maybe you're not.
Anton.
What?
You're here.
Yeah.
I
could have gotten you. You can take a picture of the black hole.
Yeah, the whole scene was nice.
I had the black hole in Calcutta.
Was that a thing?
Yes, baby. Calcutta's in India.
You caught me nodding.
Huh?
You caught me nodding.
Yes, I did, baby. I was tripping over things.
Like a dodo bird. Oh.
That's right.
Thank you. Tomorrow.
What's up? I'm a dodo bird.
I'm just a dodo. I'm a dingbat.
Baby.
Yeah.
There's a black hole again.
Oh, where's my camera? I'm making a nice picture.
That's a lovely picture, isn't it? A hole in Calcutta.
Put that up on the wall. In the living room.
I feel like I'm drinking, baby. We got no tomatoes left, do we?
Yeah. Tuna and bacon? No, leave the tuna alone, please. Because it's for casserole. Why don't you make a grilled cheese sandwich? And put tomato in it. Yeah.
this place is closed.
Yeah, it startled me. I can't see it from here. This is in space?
Yeah. It's Brian Green's black hole.
Okay, don't lose cohesion here. I'm rapidly losing cogency.
Yeah.
Know what I mean, man?
Huh?
Know what I mean, man?
No.
There's an ice cream sandwich in the freezer for you.
Where is it? Oh, yeah. I forgot, dude. Oh, here's a nice can of cream mushroom, baby.
Yeah, I know. It's for the...
It's got a pole top.
Yeah, it's for the casserole.
Mmm. It's a nice one.
And it was the store brand.
The President's Choice.
Oh my.
What?
I'm just seeing weird stuff.
Huh?
Seeing weird stuff.
What, my bum?
No, I thought that you were coming over here with a chair and you weren't even there.
You thought I was coming over?
I thought you were right there with that chair in your hand, but you weren't anywhere near here with that chair.
You were hallucinating?
Yeah.
You were hallucinating.
I was hallucinating. Okay, come on.
Huh?
I'm just trying to get myself to get the filter in this joint. Come on.
Come on. Black hole, Calcutta.
I know. They won't let you watch any more than 13 minutes of the episode. They don't do it consistently, so you can never tell which ones are the ones. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Oh.
Baby.
Excuse me.
What was that noise?
I did, yes, I farted.
You
farted?
I farted. Out of your bum hole?
Right out of my bum hole. No straw.
Is it a black hole, Calcutta?
No, it's a black hole of Queensland.
It's a black hole of Care Bear.
It's a black hole of Queensland.
She got a nice little bum. She had a boy's bum.
That's what you tell me. God, I wish he would shut up.
Right?
Yes, baby.
Say yes, baby.
Yes, baby. Excuse me.
Are you partying again?
Yes, it's a healthy function.
How many times do you party in an hour?
On average?
Yeah.
Three times?
Seven times?
No, maybe I do. I'll add up the average tonight, let you know. Oh, I'd love a piece of cheese. Yes, please.
Is the back hole cow cut it?
If that's who cut it, yeah. I should put the black hole of Calcutta cut my cheese.
Mm-hmm. Mm. You washed them, baby.
I did.
You washed your little feet. Didn't you?
I did. I wish you would just shut up.
You know how I can play with them?
Mm-hmm.
I know how to play with them, too. And let them kiss you.
Mm-hmm.
Talk to them.
I wish you would just go to fucking sleep.
I'm going to do everything to them. I'm going to work my way up.
Mm-hmm.
Should I open that window a little bit?
I think so, yeah.
I sure remember my dirty.
Bring that sausage, baby.
Are you supposed to be over to Zamboni room? You're over there skating around.
I don't work today.
No?
I don't work till Friday.
What do I hit on that, baby?
Minutes on every episode
because
it's going to, we should just pick a movie.
Yeah, pick a movie then.
Okay, how about Carrie?
She's Black Hole from Calcutta too.
To kiss. Don't sit on that chair, you might fall.
Who's delivering things to you?
What's that?
I'm delivering things to you.
Say that again, the delivery thing.
I'm delivering things to you. Is that right? Maybe. John Travolta, you were right, baby.
Yeah.
He's in Carrie. I didn't know.
What's going on over there?
I'm looking at Naughty Angie. Here is Naughty Angie.
I'm not seeing her with my mouth open like that. It's not attractive.
No, you weren't. You got it loving you.
At some point, go get a pedicure. They're warm, huh? For a change.
Nice. What?
I'm not down for the toe sucking thing yet.
Maybe I'm biting them.
I don't know. You're gonna have to work me up to that.
You're Proctor Silex.
What's that mean? I'm a square?
Yeah, all the horse carries bleeding.
Someone was just calling you. I mean, you might believe me when I tell you this, but this is kind of like what girls treated me like in school.
Yeah?
They'll gang up on me and... Well, she's being attacked by a group of girls.
Yeah, she should fight back. They'll come under all the pressure.
Yeah, you're right. I'm so bad for that.
Hey, I'm sorry.
The rag. You mean the blanket? Oh my God, what was that?
Huh?
Did you bang on the door?
No, it was a policeman. They're shooting away. No, it was that guy from the Black Hole of Calcutta.
Who was it, seriously?
Nobody, baby. I locked the door. Like I told you, you left it open.
But you also knocked on the door?
No, I banged my head.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm discombobulated.
Your teeth look like a piece of caramel candy with marshmallows on top.
Maybe. Juju, baby.
May I use that one here for you, please? Sorry, that was ticklish. Completely the wrong place anyway.
Yeah.
You were on the left side. Down near the A-hole. Can I use the lighter, please?
Yeah.
Thank you. Baby, I think you should sit down with that cigarette because you're gonna.
Calcutta?
You sit down, okay?
Okay.
Or you're gonna end up burning your face or something.
You think so?
If you go face first into the blanket, yeah. Come on, baby, sit down, please.
Okay. I'm trying to get everything over to the corner.
Just sit down for a minute, okay?
Okay.
Sit down and smoke that cigarette so you don't get hurt.
Yes, we
are. Please, baby. Baby, please sit down.
Won't you come in,
sweetheart?
Please sit down, sweetheart.
I'm dancing in circles, baby.
Yeah, I think
you need to sit down. I'm glad I'm old and I'm
kind of. I have something here I know is going to interest the doctor and you. The teenager's path to salvation through the cross of Jesus. I don't think Sue would be very interested in it. The children are wondering the willingness of sin.
That's a nice heart.
My soul is
a good heart.
Didn't you do it?
No.
I watched you do it right in front of me.
I didn't change the fits.
Huh.
I had to go wash another one out. It was carved up. That's why I gotta wipe my leg off. All those little scabs, because you stick the vid in, and the scabs go in the needle.
Mrs.
Choice. Good dog.
Yes.
What?
Nothing, sweetie.
Oh, my goodness, baby. Look.
No, it's fine. I don't need to look.
Oh.
Wasn't
that Carrie White's mother? I didn't
hear you coming. Who would she want?
I can't
deal with it. Deal with what? What do you mean?
Hi. This is the fourth one I fixed for you.
I don't think there's anything in that spoon, darling.
And all kinds. I'll do it then.
The last one that I had gave me no pins and needles.
How are you supposed to get pins and needles out of a wash?
Yeah, I know. I thought that you were going to give me whatever you didn't have.
That's what I give you. That's what's in the spoon. What was left of yours and a quarter of mine.
Oh.
I see. You had a half.
What was dropped on the floor just to wash?
What was left of yours? I took it all up.
It's crazy.
It's just been placed down, though.
I seen that movie when it was out in the Oxford Theater, 1976.
Really?
Yeah.
Was it good?
Yeah.
What theater?
Oxford.
You'll be open.
Was it nice, that theater back
yeah.
then?
Yeah.
Did you sit in the balcony?
Yeah.
Remember Highland Theater?
Yeah.
Do you remember the Highland Theater?
Yeah. Runs to the mall.
No, it's right there on the Rotary.
Yeah, I was to the mall.
Oh, yeah.
Strong out to draw, baby.
What's that?
20 after 12.
It's 20 after 12, yeah.
You broke the mirror.
That's 7 years bad luck.
Big cars spewing pollution into the air. You people with heavy feet trampling down the wilderness. You people peer into the back seats of our cars hours after you come out of the back doors of your motels. Soon, all we will have is each other.
Tupac.
Talent extraordinary for you, Tommy Ross.
What?
You know, Tommy, it's a slight difference from running touchdowns and hitting home runs.
What's happening?
Well,
nice looking, man.
Any criticisms?
I had no comment.
Anyone?
You were crying.
I told you that I have emotional control problems. Don't take it personally.
This is your fourth one.
Mm-hmm.
Glen.
Okay, line up.
Please.
Come on.
Line up!
Glen.
Oh, come on.
I'm on your feet, please.
I'm waiting for you, come. Baby, you ran away.
To be my detention. That's 50 minutes every day, starting today, on the athletic field. Get the picture? I'm not coming. That's up to you, Chris. That's up to all of you. Punishment for skipping detention is 3 days suspension. Refusal of your prom tickets. Any other thoughts? Good. Now change up.
Two, three.
10 minutes left. Stick them up your...
Show's over.